Hello everyone. The topic is decisions in financial management. We will learn what are the decisions in financial management. I would like to ask you a simple question. What is that one thing that has made you whatever you are today? And you might have n number of answers for this simple question, but that might not be all the answer for this simple question. The answer for this simple question is that whatever you are today is because of only one thing, and that is the decisions that you have taken and implemented in your life. And the second thing here is the focus is on the companies. And why do you think that certain companies have gone down and certain companies have grown so huge and they have spread all across the world? And the reason for that is, the answer for that question is the decisions that they have taken. So today we are going to discuss what are the decisions in financial management. The decisions in financial management are as follows: financing decision, investment decision, dividend decision, working capital decision. The first decision in financial management is financing decision. It is the first and foremost decision that has to be taken in the management of finance in the company. Financing decision means from where, when, and how the funds are to be acquired to meet the required capital in the company. From which source the capital has to be bought has to be decided in financing decision, and it also has to decide from what type of securities that the capital that is required for the company has to be bought. It can even decide what is the composition of various securities that should be apt or suitable for the company. And this decision is purely based on certain things, and they are: first, cost. Companies should decide this financing decision based on cost. Cost here refers to cost of raising capital and the cost of using that capital that has been bought. What is the amount that the company has to spend to raise the capital, and what the money that has to be spent by the company to use the capital that has been bought through various sources and through various securities. Second, it has to calculate what is the amount of risk that the company has to take in by choosing these sources and securities for raising the capital. Always the company should choose such kind of sources and securities where risk for the company is very less or meager. And third, it has to calculate what is the cash flow position of the company's business operations. What is the inflow of the business and what is the outflow of the business? Based on this inflow and outflow, the company has to decide on financing proportions and securities and sources. And fourth, this is the decision which is going to declare what is the level of control the company can be towards its expansion and progress in future. Because here, if the company fails in financing decision, the company might lose control of the business itself. So it has to properly decide whether to control and to control in what way, so that the company will have more profits to meet the liabilities of the company, to increase the assets of the company. If the securities and sources are chosen well, then the company will have more profits and then the company will be in good control. And last, this decision will be based on the condition of the market. the condition of the capital market and money market, how the market is going to respond to the requirement of the capital needs of a company. Is it very favorable? Is that market filled with investors? In such case, getting money from those market is really easy for the company, and thus financing decision is going to be based on all these things. And based on these things, if the decision is going to be taken, the decision is going to be really good for the company, and that will result in better growth of the company as well. The second important decision in financial management is investment decision. In the first decision, financing decision, the company and the financial management had decided from where, from which source and from which securities money should be bought to the company to meet the capital requirements of the company. In the second decision, that is investment decision, it has to decide in which assets and projects the money that has been bought should be invested in a profitable manner. This decision plays important role because this is going to help in the operations of the business, because these are the assets and projects in which money is going to be pumped in, which is going to result in the profits of the company if the decision is made in profitable way. If the company is going to invest in profitable assets and projects is the major concern here. Here the decision will be focused on the cash flow of the project or asset. From that particular asset or project, whichever is going to be invested in, how that project or asset is going to give back the cash flows for the company to meet all the liabilities that is being borne by the company, how to repay the loan, all those things will be focused here, and thus it is going to be on the base of cash flow. Second, it will be based on the profitability of the asset or project. In whatever project or asset that the company is going to invest in, what is the level or rate of profit out of that project or profit is going to be the criteria for investment. And the company might have various investment criteria as well. How to pump in, at what rate to invest the money in the projects. Based on those things, the company will decide the investment decision. And here the focus is to get back the capital as it has invested sooner, and the second, to get some kind of profit extra more than whatever it is investing in the project is major concern here. And based on all these things, investment decision has to be made by the company. The third important decision in financial management is dividend decision. The first being financing decision, deciding from where the money has to be bought to meet the company's capital requirements, and the second being investing decision, deciding on the investments that are to be made in suitable projects and assets for profitable position of the company. And if these decisions are done in a proper way, it is going to result in more profits for the company, and thus resulting in the third decision called as dividend decision. Here the company has to decide what is the amount of money that has to be segregated and what is the amount of money that has to be distributed. Here the segregation has to be made from the profits for two sources, that is, one is the amount to be distributed for the equity shareholders as earnings per share or dividend, and second, for the money that has to be kept as retained earnings from the profits. So what is the percentage that has to be given as dividends, and what is the amount or share or percentage that has to be kept aside as retained earnings has to be decided in this third decision called as dividend decision. It has to focus on the earnings, what is the rate or level of earnings. If it is earning more, and it can then set aside more for each source. If not, it has to be focusing on some other source for retained earnings or capital need purpose. how much the company is depending on earnings of the company. Major focus is here. If the company is having no dependence on the earnings of the company, if the company is having various other sources for capital needs, then there is no problem for the company to depend on the earnings for capital need purpose. If not, the company has to reap in, dig in the earnings to finance major capital requirement needs of the company. And third, it has to balance dividends. How it is going to balance dividends? In case if every year the company is going to earn the same kind of profits, no problem. If the company is going to have fluctuating problems, fluctuating profits, in that case company is going to have to face major problems. In such case, the company has to retain some kind of profit this year, giving less amount of dividend, wherein the saved profits will be given as dividend in the next coming years, because the future is uncertain. In case in future if the company is not going to earn enough profit, in that case the money that is being earned today will be given as profits or dividends in the next coming years. So that is how the company is going to balance dividends, becomes a major focus. And how much the company is going to develop and use the opportunities available. If there is more profits flowing in because of those decisions, then the company can retain more earnings, and then that earnings that is retained by the company can be used for expansion, diversification or modernization or any other developmental operations in the company, so that company can grow furthermore. So dividendation is more important, and which is playing a major role in the growth of the company as well. The fourth decision in financial management is working capital decision. This decision is nothing but keeping the money ready to meet the day-to-day expenses in the business, to make the business run in a smooth way without any hindrances. And to meet this, the company has to decide how much should be the working capital and from which source the company can reap in the money that is required for the day-to-day operations of the business. And for this purpose, the company should ensure itself that it has enough liquidity, that liquid cash is available to meet the day-to-day expenses. And this can be met only if the company is in profitable position. Only if the company is in profitable position, and if the company is earning more profits, then for sure it can be guaranteed that the company will have better liquidity position and can meet all the day-to-day expenses without any problem. And third, it also depends on the company's ability to collect, and collect at fast pace how the current assets are managed by the company, how soon the current assets are collected by the company to meet the various working capital needs of the company, thus having a better decision in working capital management. Hence, these are the four major decisions in financial management. We learnt all the decisions in financial management. I hope this presentation gave you little understanding towards the topic decisions in financial management. For further reading, please refer these books. Thanks for listening.